being obedient. Lord Jesus, help us, please. Make the difference. Oh, of alma mater. Do it again.
But the thing is, everything derives from them.
Exactly.
Everything.
That's
everything. You can't help it. Like, do it. It's gonna come out whatever you can play classical and it's gonna come out some way. Thank you. that voice and sing.
Thank you. Thank you. Attention, please. May I have your attention, please? Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We are delighted you are present to share in this great and historic day at Dillard University. We ask your cooperation during the Dillard University commencement that we all know is different from our past commencements. First, compliance with local COVID-19 guidelines. We ask that you keep your face coverings on for the duration of the event. We also ask that you remain in your seats to maintain safe distancing and to ensure that everyone is able to enjoy the program as planned. Finally, for reasons of safety, please keep the aisles clear at all times. Now we know that under normal circumstances, everyone can get those wonderful, candid, one-of-a-kind photos, but we must recognize that protecting everyone's health is of the utmost importance. Therefore, only our designated professional photographers will take pictures this morning, particularly during the conferring of the degrees. We know that you would love to gather with the graduates at the commencement, but state and local guidelines require that everyone depart the campus immediately after today's ceremony. We really appreciate your understanding on this. The class of 2021 will arrive shortly from Dent Hall to take their places on the Rosa Freeman Keller Avenue of the Oaks to celebrate with all of us who are assembled here today. Ladies and gentlemen, now this long-awaited, much-prayed-for day, Commencement 2021.
Thank you. journey across the
I wanna be the change, a change for DU. An unshakable change, the start of something new. Change that can move mountains. Change that can cross the seas. Change that could help others. Change that will make them believe that we can make this happen, that we can make this right, that we can conquer anything in our sight. So come be you. Let's do it together. Yeah, yeah. So come be you. Let's do it together.
Greetings to the graduating class of 2021. Today is the day, the final day of our college journey. Congratulations, you've done it. Despite all the obstacles thrown your way and the hardships that you have faced, you persevered and you've made it to this momentous day. I want all of you to think back to who you were when you first began at Dillard and compare that person to who you are now. Today, I want you to take pride in how you have grown as a person and in everything that you have accomplished. While it was your efforts that have led you to this day, I want to give thanks to those who supported our journey. Thank you to the families of graduates for your encouragement. Thank you to professors and staff for giving us your knowledge and nurturing. And thank you to my fellow classmates for pushing each other to be the best persons that we can be. As we move forward into our lives, use the lessons that you have learned in Dillard to improve and maintain the connections that you have made. I will leave you with this quote from Oprah Winfrey. Your life's journey is about learning to become more of who you are and fulfilling the highest, truest expression of yourself as a human being.
Thank you to God. Thank you to my family, my friends in the Dillard community who has made this moment possible. Future wrote a song in 2017 entitled Mask Off. As the song title suggests, Future's taking the mask off of himself and showing the world some of his vulnerabilities. In March of 2020, many of us shifted to our new normal and began wearing facial coverings in order to combat COVID-19 and flatten the curve. While young people across the globe were taking metaphorical masks off. I'm sure during this graduation season, people will tell you about the endless possibilities and the bright future that you have ahead of you, but I want to speak to the person you are now. When I look at the graduating class at Dillard University, I see a group of people who are anti-maskers, a group of people that have taken the mask off of oppressive policies, a group of people that have taken masks off of things that stop them from being their authentic selves. You've taken masks off in classrooms, hospitals, doctor's offices, courtrooms, law offices, and even right here on Gentilly, you've taken the mask off. And you will continue to take the mask off of things that stop you from being yourself and stop your peers from being successful. As one of the valedictorians of the graduating class, I'm proclaiming that May 15th is the day that the mask mandate is lifted. No longer will you equate your IQ with the use of colloquialisms and euphemisms. Or will they equate your IQ with your accoutrement? Or will they equate who you are based on the color of your skin? The mask is off. The graduating class of 2021 has been exactly like Future, taking the mask off of places that they don't belong. For so long you have done this, and May 15th is just a day that you publicly acknowledge that you're an anti-masker. Congratulations for making it thus far. And congratulations to the bright future that you all have ahead of you in becoming the greatest anti-maskers that this world has ever seen. Push the envelope. Break the glass ceiling. You've done it before, and you'll continue to do it. I'm grateful to know you and excited about the future that we have together. Peace and power.
unshakable change. The start of something new. Change that can move mountains. Change that can cross the seas. Change that can help others. Change that can make them believe that we can make this happen, that we can make this right, that we can conquer anything in our sight. So come, come to you. Let's do it together. Yeah, yeah. So come, come to you. Let's do it together. So come, come to you. Let's do it together.
And if you would kindly turn to your left, you will see that our speaker has arrived. Graduates, now is your opportunity to take your candidates. So pull out your phones as we greet Commencement Speaker 2021. Sorry, I'm a year behind. Actor and producer Michael Ealy. Graduates, parents, and friends, welcome to Commencement 2021, a day we have looked forward to for the last 9 months. Due to state and local guidelines, there are some changes to the order of exercises, some of which you have just witnessed. Among them is the degree conferral, which has been moved to the end of the program. For those of you who are watching via live stream, degrees will be called alphabetically by college, starting with the College of Arts and Sciences, then the College of Business, and ending with the College of Nursing. In addition, there is no en masse standing, so you will remain seated for the singing of Lift Every Voice and Sing, the invocation, the Alumni Association induction, and the benediction. To comply with state and city guidelines, each graduate, upon receiving his or her degree, will exit the stage and return to Ditt Hall. There is one change to the program. The honorary degree conferral will occur immediately following the commencement address. Now, Sharanda Lewis, 21, will lead us in singing Lift Every Voice and Sing. Afterwards, please follow your program as printed.
We Let us pray. Dear God, we pray for our Dillard University class of 2021 graduates today and lift them before you. We thank you so much for these we love and for the work you are continuing to do in their lives. They are the gifts you have given unto us and to many others. And during the season of new beginnings, we ask that you would make their way clear. We ask that you would keep their footsteps firm. We ask that you would remind them that you are with them always. May they sense the freshness of your spirit over their lives in amazing ways. May they be strengthened. May they be instilled with hope for the new roads you have in store for them. And today again, we release our children straight into your tender care because we know that you have already destined them. We thank you in advance for all you have in store for this day and days to come and years, for their lives and lives they will impact. We pray for protection, for your covering, that you would surround their lives with a shield, protect their coming and their going. We ask that you would help them to live aware in a dark world and keep harm or evil intent far away from them. We ask that you would hide them in the safety of your powerful presence. Our world is currently anxious, is fearful and uncertain. We pray for our graduates. We pray that they are filled with your courage and your strength, that they may be a light to their friends and to the neighbors in this uncertain time. We ask for your wisdom and clear direction over their lives, that you would give them understanding beyond their years. Thank you, O God, for your timing is perfect. We pray that you would direct their steps, their path, their plans for them would prosper, that every place you have determined that they walk would be paved clear. We ask that you open doors that need to be opened. We pray that you close every one that should be shut tight. Allow every gift, every treasure you have placed inside of them to grow, to develop and flourish, to bring glory. We ask that you will remind them every day how much you love them and that you would find security and confidence fulfilling their purpose in you. We ask that you would teach them that you are always and fill them with the unquenchable desire to yearn and to hunger more for the things of you. We ask for your peace to cover them. We ask for laughter and joy to fill their days. We ask that you would raise up greatness in their lives. We pray, God, that you will continue to fill us as we invite you to continue to lead, guide, and direct us, that you would be the lamp for our feet and the light to their path. Shine over them and us. Fill them with your spirit. Bless them with your favor coming in and your peace going out. In your son's Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good morning. On behalf of the Dillard University Board of Trustees, I extend greetings and congratulations to the class of 2021. Welcome parents, family members, and friends who've joined us here on the historic Avenue of the Oaks and from your homes via live stream. I also recognize the faculty and staff who've worked tirelessly to help the mighty class of 2021 to this wonderful day. I'm especially honored to welcome award-winning actor and producer Michael Ealy to Dillard for our commencement exercise. It is a great honor to officially greet each of you as we continue to persist through trying times. Frederick Douglass once said, "If there is no struggle, there is no progress." Without question, that certainly rings true today. Having completed your Dillard degree in these difficult times, you've already experienced what it means to take on life's challenges. We're confident that you have done so and are doing so as only a Dillard graduate can. At Dillard University, we stand true to our motto, ex fide fortis, strength from faith. And the past 14 months have only made us stronger. These oaks that are doing this majestic way are a symbol of the strength of this institution. They represent the enduring spirit of the classes that preceded yours and the work of the instructors and leaders of this university to make this truly a special place. It is an honor to watch you move on into the select company of a Dillard family whose branches extend far and wide. Know that no matter where you go with the spirit and support of your fellow Blue Devils. Again, congratulations.
Good morning, President Kimbrough, Board of Trustees, honored guests, faculty, staff, alumni, family, and the class of 2021. My name is Toya Smith, and I'm an Urban Studies and Public Policy major from Fort Worth, Texas, and I've had the distinct honor this year of serving as the class of 2021 senior class president. It is an honor and a pleasure to announce today's commencement speaker. Michael Ealy was born in Washington, D.C. and raised in Silver Spring, Maryland. He is a renowned actor. Ealy graduated from the University of Maryland in College Park with a degree in English. At 19 years old, he began his acting career. Michael Ealy has established himself as one of the leading men in film, seamlessly transitioning from television to movie screens. He's received nominations for the Teen Choice Awards, NAACP Emmys Awards, and the Golden Globe Awards. In his first film, he played Greg in Kissing Jessica Stein, but of course, we know and love him as Ricky Nash in Barbershop. To quote Mr. Ealy, "I hope that they'll remember the man, not the actor. As we sit on the Avenue of the Oaks this morning, I hope we all remember who we are, beyond the titles and rewards that will inevitably come our way." Without further ado, please help me give an enthusiastic Dillard University welcome to Michael Ealy.
Good morning. It is indeed early. This is a very, very beautiful morning. I don't think it could have been more beautiful than this. Looking out at you is just absolutely amazing and beautiful. I'm stalling because I'm nervous. I've never done this before, and yeah, appreciate it. I want to say thank you to all of the faculty and staff for having me today. Dr. Kimbrough, it's been an honor to meet you. And everyone else I was able to meet in the office there. It's good to be in New Orleans. And it's amazing to look out and see you guys and what you're about to accomplish and what you've already accomplished. I want to thank you, all the students, the graduating class of 2021, for allowing me to be your speaker at your commencement. You have had some amazing speakers here in the past. I mean amazing. It was pretty intimidating to say yes. And I'm not sure why or how qualified I am to speak here today, but my mother and father always taught me that when my people call, I answer. So So I want to start off with a little bit of a disclaimer. A couple years ago, Robert Smith paid off the student debt at Morehouse. That's not going to happen today. I apologize. And I believe last week it was John Legend who closed his speech by singing Glory at another university. And well, that's not going to happen today. So in a lot of ways, I genuinely feel bad for you. You got, in my opinion, the short end of the stick. Not because I can't pay off your loans, I can't. Or because I can't sing like John. I don't want to show him up. But without a grand gesture that resonates and reverberates into the ether of social media, one could have the debate that in these times, without it being recorded or going viral, does it even really exist? This perhaps is a true question your generation is confronted with daily. And for the time being, let's just have a conversation between me and you, shall we? My guess is that me standing here or just having any commencement speaker in general may soon be considered antiquated in its presentation. Does that make sense? I mean, can you imagine what this ceremony may look like for your children? I know you're thinking, Michael, I'm just trying to graduate, dog. I ain't thinking about babies right now, but I get it. As a parent of two, I have no choice. Nothing in my life has gone according to plan, so I've had to adjust. I've had to move with the punches and go with the flow, but mostly I've learned that life is more about being present. However, being present is impossible if you're not ready. I learned to be ready for whatever because eventually everything changes. Now, I'll give you an example. In my business, we have the Oscars, right? And 2 years ago, they held that ceremony for the first time with no host. Ironically, no one missed the host, and there was no real uproar about it. Some people actually preferred it that way. Traditions change. People change. Politics change. If there's anything the last 25 years has taught me, it's that I can't plan on things remaining the same for long. When I got into my business, things were a little bit more simple. As an actor, you could be on stage, you could be in TV, you could be in films. YouTube was in its infant stages, and reality TV was relegated to MTV. Essentially, talent was needed, but like I said, things don't remain the same. I had to accept that and adjust. Not long after I got what I considered at the time my most pivotal role of tea cake in the movie Their Eyes Were Watching God, based on Zora Neale Hurston's novel, I remember feeling like I was on top of the world. I was confident that my career was heading in the right direction. I had just been selected for the part by the almighty Oprah and Halle Berry, who had just won the Academy Award. I was like, I'm in good shape. My days of fearing that I would somehow return to waiting tables and having no health insurance despite having a college degree were over. I got comfortable. I got ahead of myself. I thought to myself, Mama, I made it. In hindsight, I was not only naive but foolish. I wasn't ready. I was bamboozled into thinking that the struggle was over and the future was bright. I was led to believe that things would fall into place and stardom was certain. Marvel should be calling any minute now. Things change. I had to get ready. You are the class that will infamously be known as the class that survived the global pandemic. Yes. When you started college, did they say look to the person to your right, then look to the person to your left? One, if not both, may not be here when you graduate? Well, I'm certain some of your incoming classmates as freshmen didn't make it, and this is cause for pride and concern. Be prideful because some way, somehow, you made it through. You showed resilience and fortitude, well done. You showed Others, for whatever reasons, they simply did not make it. I remember after I graduated, this feeling being one of the first cold truths about life. Everyone won't make it to the finish line. Now, when I think about this theory, this truth, I am deeply concerned by the question that remains. Who did you help get to the finish line? Did you reach back and make sure that others got there too? We live in a time where technology is sold to us as a mechanism that unites us all, and sometimes it does. Yet when you walk down a busy city street, no one is looking up, no one is connected. If a woman were to fall down, many of us will walk right by without even noticing. We are fully absorbed in our own bubbles. Can you repeat after me, please? Stay ready so you don't have to get ready. I remember the first time I heard that phrase. I was on set shooting a scene back in 2004. I think you guys were four. I was shooting with a real veteran who, like my father, was a US Marine. He dropped that gin on me right in between takes after the director asked if we were ready to shoot. And it blew my mind. I couldn't focus. It made so much sense. It was profound in its simplicity and prophetic in its truth. It was also one of the hardest adjustments to make in life. As an actor, I took it to mean study harder, learn different dialects or an instrument like guitar or piano so you don't have to do a crash course when a role comes up that requires it. It meant learn and study the mediums of screen acting versus theater, learn voice and movement. It meant even if you had dreams of being a movie star, do some television shows from sitcoms to hour-long dramas, just in case those movie roles get harder and harder to come by. Just in case Marvel doesn't call. If you're confused and asking, what should I stay ready for, Michael? The answer is pretty interesting and also internal. Life isn't linear. There's no one way to do much of anything anymore. We grow up with different circumstances. We come from different backgrounds. How to be human in this world is an ever-evolving quest relative to each individual, striving for definition and clarity. The answers we seek typically come in the lessons we learn the hard way. The next time failure comes, don't look at it as a bottomless pit, but as a hurdle. Does a child with a disability keep you from being the father you always dreamed of? Being a woman struggling with infertility doesn't make you any less of a woman. Getting that job you always dreamed of, then slowly learning that you never really loved that profession and would much rather travel the world taking photographs of your experiences, does that make you a failure or someone who listens to their heart? The answers like life are rooted in desire. What do you want for yourself? Once you know that answer, take the steps needed to be ready so you don't have to get ready. My parents' generation was technically the first generation that had the opportunity to have a career, not a job, a career. A job is something you have to do, a career is something you want to do. While sometimes they overlap, in theory, you should never think of your career as a job. That being said, prior to their generation, many folks, my grandparents included, were of the ilk that I just need a job to take care of my family, and they weren't wrong. They worked within the system. Women were raised to marry back then. Rather than be seen or heard as fully molded and thoughtful individuals with dreams and aspirations outside of marriage, they too worked within the system. But look at you now. Change is a good thing. One could argue that my generation was the first generation of black people to start off with what we then deemed unlimited possibilities. We could have a career. We could get good jobs with benefits in the private sector and them good government jobs with great benefits, and even get a big house and be just like white folks. For some of us, this is reality, but for most of us, this is just another dream sold to us on a platter of Americana. I am here today to tell you that America doesn't need more people of color fighting for good jobs and fulfilled dreams. That is to be expected. America doesn't need black versions of Bill Gates and Jeff Bezos. When we use that language, black versions, we set a cruel standard for which we unknowingly give truth to power. When was the last time you heard someone white referred to as the next Oprah? I'll wait. Why is the coin one-sided? We need Toya Smith. Do you see how the lack of juxtaposition doesn't hinder the beauty of what I said? It just needs to be said. Thank you. What America needs is more individuals like you, individuals who think individually and don't follow the herd, individuals that don't live for the viral approval of others and don't struggle to fit in. I am always amused when someone says that their spouse is struggling to fit in at work. Fit in to what? Fit into what? Did you, class of 2021, work hard? Did I just lose it? Yes, sorry. Did you, class of 2021, work hard to graduate from this university during a global pandemic only to get into the workforce and just fit in? Black people have been trying for years to fit into what America has decided is American. Black people have always been judging themselves according to a standard that we never established. We need individuals like you whose greatest critics are themselves. Black people have literally died fighting for what the ruling class in this country assume as their natural-born domestic rights, despite never having a legitimate natural-born claim to this land. Thusly, we need individuals like you who live and operate from truth, not revisionist history passed down through corrupt public school systems. We need individuals like you who no longer live to seek acceptance from a country that can't protect them. Excuse me, that refuses to protect them. We need individuals like you who believe in a community as a form of intimacy, not a construct or a voting block. Define your own community. These are the kinds of individuals who stay ready. At this point, if you feel like I'm telling you not to obey the law or break away from those tenets that society deems as norms, you might not be entirely wrong. I am not encouraging you to break the law or the system. I am encouraging you to think of a world in which the system doesn't exist. When I moved to New York City after graduating college from the University of Maryland, I worked in a Jamaican restaurant filled with the staff from various parts of the Caribbean. I was amazed at the level of confidence they all had. I always imagined that this confidence came from attending an HBCU. They never seemed to have the same self-doubt I had. There was no chip on their shoulders. It didn't take long before I learned that this confidence came from growing up as members of the majority from their respective countries. They had support and standards of beauty that I didn't have, and it was beautiful. The system here in this country had given me a complex. I also want to encourage you to change the fundamental thinking that you as an individual must adhere to any system. If a system is in place, and believe me, there are many in this country, then one's individuality is inherently in jeopardy. Change the system here because that system has never been in place to help you. In fact, your education should teach you that it is America's historically flawed systems that have helped not only to perpetuate your place and status in society, but also have assisted in the brainwashing of others into thinking much too highly of their superiority. The system's in place to keep light skin and dark skin separated by worth, deeply permeate the minds of many across the globe, from America to South America to India to the Middle East and even Asia. It is toxic, so you gotta stay ready. You have to think as an individual, and you have to break free of what the past has shown you, only to know that the future is what you make for yourself and your community. For the record, this mindset is only considered radical by those who live in fear of losing power. But I say it again, define your own community and stay ready. Okay, so this part may get me in trouble with the parents. Class of 2021, make certain that when you wake up tomorrow, you are not taking steps in fulfilling only the dreams of your parents. Fulfill your own dreams, find your own way as an individual. Family systems can be toxic as well. I've seen it firsthand. To the parents, let's give you a round of applause for getting them here. Let me start with that. It is all right to dream big for your kids and support them, but be wary of forcing upon them your dreams deferred. Make sure that you are taking whatever the necessary steps are that will get you to where you want to be. Take it day by day and step by step. People always say, follow the blueprint of so-and-so. I say, make your own damn blueprint. And let the achievements and dreams of others remain where they should be, in their corner and separate from anything and everything that makes you special and you unique and you qualified to be your best self, full of self-confidence and self-determination and a healthy sense of individualism. You may very well be on your way to being the first Black. Stop right there. You know what? You could be the next Black. Stop right there. That ain't a goal. That's a title. Be what you want to be in life, because as an individual, it will bring you happiness without tearing apart the lives of others. Yes, it may inspire others to follow you down your path, but that is not why you do it. The why is inside you. And I stand here to look at you and to tell you to look inside yourself and strip yourself of any ideology about any glory coming to you if you do. Just do it. Just do it. I recently read somewhere that happiness is the new rich. Time will tell. Earlier, I explained how staying ready affected me as an actor. Now I want to explain how it affected me as a man. I've lost two parents in the last decade. Didn't see it coming. Losing one parent is brutal enough. Losing two can easily be considered an emotional apocalypse. I wasn't ready, at least I didn't think I was. Now, when I played Tea Cake and their eyes were watching God, I learned a very valuable lesson. We are here for a time. We are here for a time. For that character, his time came to an abrupt end once his purpose was fulfilled. For some, making a lot of money, being famous, or getting married and having children, maybe a good job, that is purpose. For Tea Cake, it was helping Janie figure out how to love herself. After that was accomplished, it was actually okay and somewhat heroic for him to die. His work here on earth was done. And I realized that my parents' work was done and that my time with them was spent preparing me for life without them. In essence, I was ready. What I took from playing Tea Cake can help you as it did me. Today, you will walk across this stage and we'll all clap and be proud of you, not only for what you've accomplished in graduating from this fine institution, but mostly for what your potential is moving forward from here. And also, what you give back later on down the road. From the outside looking in, it seems as though the best thing you have going for you as young people is time. Time someone laid up in the hospital right now doesn't have. Take full advantage of this most precious asset. Time has less to do with what you do and more to do with who you are and what you believe. I'm of the ilk that if you have time, you have purpose. Live in that. In closing, are you ready so you don't have to get ready when the time comes and your new reality is right in front of you and it challenges everything you ever dreamed possible or imagined? Or will you be scared because someone told you that you don't fit in? Leave this place knowing yourself. Leave this place knowing you will not be a follower. Leave this place knowing that time is on your side, but not to be wasted. Leave this place thinking of yourself as an individual whose goals and dreams will one day eradicate the system mentality that has plagued those that has come before you and those that are currently subscribing to groupthink. Leave this place knowing that as an individual, you can still be inclusive in your community. Leave this place knowing that you are ready for most anything. Pandemics, racism, politics, police brutality, homophobia, xenophobia, and the list goes on, but worst of them all is self-doubt and self-hatred. It starts within you. Leave this place knowing that His grace is inside you. And no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Y'all want me to sing it? I told John I wouldn't do it, but take a look at your neighbor and repeat after me. I stay ready. So I don't have to get ready. Dillard University class of 2021, faculty and staff. We got through it. Thank you so much for having me. I look forward to seeing how each and every one of you grow. I love you and you, I genuinely appreciate that. I think it might have meant more to me than it did to you. So God bless you and onward.
Thank you very much, Mr. Ealy, for those thought-provoking words. It was very apparent that you are an English major, the way you were able to put pen to paper. Okay. Okay. So, Mr. President, it is my privilege to present to you Michael Ealy as a candidate for the honorary degree of Doctor of Humane Letters.
When we were in the office, he asked me where I was from, and I said Atlanta. And so being from Atlanta, I'm going to tell y'all what he just did. We call sandbagging, because he came up here, oh, I'm nervous, and then he just started spitting fire. You know what I'm saying? He just psyched us all out, but that's all right. With much delight today, we celebrate and honor a talented creative force who makes us laugh and challenges us to think deeply. Man, he did that thing. I got to watch it again later on today. That was wonderful. Michael Ealy began his acting career in the early 2000s with numerous film and television credits to his name. Mr. Ealy has emerged as one of Hollywood's most sought-after actors. He is a critically acclaimed actor, having received the Black Reel Award in 2005 for his role in Their Eyes Were Watching God, and the African American Film Critics Award in 2010 for his role in For Colored Girls. A graduate of the University of Maryland College Park with a degree in English, Mr. Ealy supports many charities and causes, including the American Association of Retired Persons, NAACP, Urban Arts Partnership, At-Risk Disadvantaged Youth, Education, and Civil Rights, among others. And really, for me, the award that I don't think anybody realizes is that he really has the leading ladies lottery winner award. Gabrielle Union, Megan Good, Beyonce, Eve, Halle Berry, Kimberly Elise, Sanaa Lathan, Taraji P. Henson. I'm so jealous of this man right here. Jealous. But therefore, on recommendation of the faculty and with approval by the Dillard University Board of Trustees, I confer upon you the honorary degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa, with all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereunto.
Mama, I made it.
President Kimbrough, it gives me great pleasure to present to you the top graduates in the class of 2021. Victoria Robertson and Traylon Rogers, please stand and come forward. Both Victoria and Traylon have completed their coursework with a perfect 4.0 cumulative grade point average and are well-deserving of the distinction of valedictorian. In recognition of their accomplishment, each of them will receive the Benjamin E. Mays, the Samuel Du Bois Cook Presidential Scholarship, which is annually awarded to the top graduating senior who has maintained an exemplary academic record. Victoria, a Kenner, Louisiana native, is a psychology major and a social work minor at Dillard University. As a student, Victoria has been a member of the Thompson Cook Honors Program, served as the secretary and vice president for the Psi Chi International Honor Society in Psychology, the parliamentarian of the K.B. Clark Psychology Club, and the events manager and freshman representative of the Pre-Alumni Council. Victoria is a member of the Leadership Alliance and was a Mellon Research Fellow at Johns Hopkins University, where she was awarded a Certificate of Excellence in Undergraduate Research. Victoria has also acted as a student researcher at Dillard, presented at several undergraduate research symposiums, and has been published in not one, but two peer-reviewed journals. She has been a recipient of the Dillard University Presidential Scholarship and the UNCF Wells Fargo Scholarship. Victoria has been accepted into three doctoral programs. In the fall, she plans to attend Adler University in Chicago, Illinois, as a recipient of their merit scholarship to get her doctoral degree in clinical psychology. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating Victoria Robertson, valedictorian of the class of 2021. Traylon T. Rogers is a native of Arlington, Texas. Traylon intends to use his degree in urban studies and public policy to work in the government field while obtaining his Juris Doctorate. He is an alumnus of Judge Barefoot Sanders Law Magnet at Townview and currently serves as a national board member for the NAACP and the Assistant Secretary of the Board. At the ripe old age of 21, Traylon is the youngest person to be elected as a national officer of the NAACP. He serves as the vice chair of the Elections Supervisory Membership and Units and the Legal Committees. Traylon is also a member of Dillard University's nationally ranked mock trial team and a two-term Student Government Association president. Traylon has served in many leadership roles throughout his life, including he has served as vice chairman of the City of Dallas Youth Commission, chairman of the NAACP National Youth Work Committee, and president of the Dallas NAACP Youth Council. Traylon's proudest moment as the president of the Dallas Youth Council was when he led a district-wide walkout to bring awareness to gun violence in schools. In the position of chairman of the NYWC, he created great task force that addressed social justice issues that had an impact on youth in the NAACP nationwide. Traylon is a member of Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated, and he is a Kappa Fellow. He serves as chairman of Intake and was recently recognized as the undergraduate brother with the highest GPA. Traylon has been the recipient of several awards, including the Torchbearer Award, the NAACP NYWC Chairman's Award, the City of Dallas Appreciation for Dedication and Service to the Community Award, the Texas NAACP State Conference Torchbearers Award, and Rice University Best Attorney Award. Traylon plans to attend either the University of Texas School of Law or the University of California Berkeley School of Law with support from the Marshall Motley Scholars Program, an innovative scholarship program designed to produce a highly skilled cadre of racial justice attorneys committed to working in the southern region of the United States. Ladies and gentlemen, join me in congratulating Traylon Rogers, valedictorian of the class of 2021.
President Kimbrough, I am delighted to present to you the members of the class of 1971 who are commemorating the 50th anniversary of their graduation from Dillard University. Although they are unable to be with us in person, we want to honor them for their professional and personal accomplishments and thank them for their service to their alma mater. Clement Ross Ashford, Benny L. Bowden, Gail Elise Bowie, Nyjah Domaine Bynum, Stephanie Camp Carey, Jessica Netter Crawford, Michael L. Daly, Linda F. Delisha Kenny, Gwendolyn J. Dennis Mack, Deborah Lufroy Ewer, Roxanne Bell Henderson, Karen Clark Hunter, Coretta Robinson Jefferson, Margaret Langham Johnson, Warren Allen Jones, Alethea Lyons Johnson, Deanna Vaughn, Dorothy Wallace Johnson, Joanne Jones Burbridge, Brenda Joyce Kennedy, Janice Davis Lee, Peggy Grace Reedham Loeb, Frank J. Mason, Bernice Johnson McMillan, Nina Laverne Medlock, Linda Turner Millam, Angelin Bell Morgan, Carolyn Marie Reed Lewis, Janet Sandra Sias Roberts, Yvonne Blackston Sharp, Dolores Wilkerson Smith, Piola Smith Smith, Jennifer Craig Steele, Bruce Myers Stewart, Ruth Juanita Burks Stewart, Carl Edmund Stewart, David L. Sullivan, Sylvia Elaine Taylor, Betty Davis Vernado, Jimmy N. Varnado, Leroy Walker, Muriel M. Walker, Dolores Wallace, Flynn Johnson Wallace, Jr., Marsha A. Marlborough Wallace, Ida May Warfield, Ronald H. White, Errol G. Williams, Gloria R. Williams. Thank you, class of 1971.
I'm going to ask one of those members of the class of 1971, Frank Mason, if he'll come next to me at the podium. Dr. Page, I jumped all over you. I'm sorry. She's supposed to say, President Kimbrough, it is my privilege to present to you Frank Mason, recipient of the Presidential Medal of Honor. My bad. Frank, your service to Dillard University has been nothing short of stellar. As a student, you were active on campus, fighting for civil rights as well as rights for students on campus. You left these hallowed grounds 50 years ago to launch a successful banking career. Afterwards, you set the business world ablaze by becoming a highly successful entrepreneur. As owner of a number of McDonald's restaurants in New Jersey, you put your education and experience to work to create opportunities not only for yourself, but also countless employees whose lives were touched by your business acumen. In the midst of running a business, you found time to dedicate your efforts and resources to advancing your alma mater. For the past 25 years, you have served on the Board of Trustees. During that time, you served as chair of the Buildings and Grounds Committee. Your service to this committee was particularly profound in the aftermath of Hurricane Katrina. With your leadership, Dillard was able to restore this beautiful campus to what we are enjoying today. You also served as vice chair of the Governance Committee, during which time the board has maintained a diverse and robust body that has worked tirelessly to keep Dillard strong. You carved a path for young men at Dillard by creating the Robert Todd Mason Scholarship that pays for a full ride every year. Several generations of Dillard alumni have earned a college degree because of you. You have been a living example of servant leadership. As you retire from active board membership and move to trustee emeritus status, and as you celebrate your golden anniversary from graduating from Dillard, we salute you for your service and commitment to Dillard University. It is my honor to present you with this Presidential Medal. And just very briefly, Frank Mason is really the epitome of what a trustee should be. Always supportive, always asking really tough questions and making sure we're thinking forward, but really has been a great supporter of the institution. So in my 9 years here, I have been just pleased to know and get to know Frank. So I just want to personally thank you for everything you've done for me as president, and your support has been just tremendous. So I'm really excited to present this Presidential Medal to you today.
It's certainly an honor to receive this award. I thank the university for all it's done for me, and I only hope that as I look out at this great class, that 50 years from today, you will be here as well. God bless all of you.
It is my pleasure to greet you on behalf of the Dillard University National Alumni Association and its over 11,000 alumni and distinguished alumni of this great institution. I would like to take the opportunity once again to congratulate the members of the class of 1971 as you celebrate your 50th anniversary of graduation. In normal circumstances at this point, I would ask the graduates to stand and raise their right hand and repeat after me. However, due to state and local, they are unable to stand today. So graduates, I ask that you simply raise your hands and repeat after me. I state your name. Promise to uphold the high standards and ideals which Dillard alumni demonstrate. I promise to support my alma mater, to assure that it remains financially and academically strong, I will continue to strive for excellence throughout my life pursuits and represent Dillard University locally, nationally, and internationally with dignity and honor. So help me God. Thank you. And congratulations, my fellow Dillard brothers and sisters. Welcome to the National Alumni Association. Please remember, your first year is on us. So make sure you go to donor.org and register. We are so happy to invite you all into the National Alumni Association. Fair Dillard forever.
All right, we're getting close to that time when you will be able to walk across the stage. You know, every year during this time, I do what I call senior shout-outs to share with the audience some interesting facts about you, the class, your accomplishments, legacy, and futures. This is something I've done every year as a president, so this is my 16th time, but because of some of the restrictions, we actually videotape some of these earlier, and they'll be available online. So I'm gonna do a couple of groups. I know they say we're not supposed to do a lot of standing, but we're gonna do a little now anyway, because I still need people to sort of get a feeling as to who's in this class. So for honor graduates, if you're graduating cum laude, please stand. Thank you. If you're graduating magna cum laude, please stand. If you are graduating summa cum laude, please stand. If you are the first in your family to graduate from college, please stand. If you are completing college today after starting more than 10 years ago, these are persisters, please stand. Anybody who started 10 years ago and now... Thank you. And then the overachievers, if you're graduating in 3 years, stand up. I want to introduce quickly the winners of the Best All-Around Prize. This award dates back to the 1950s when it was called the Ernest W. Armstrong Award. Beginning in 2013, it became the William Sutton Prize, named for Dr. William Sutton, who graduated from Dillard in 1953 and who was a class president for 3 years, football captain, and a science major who later taught on the faculty for 20 years and served as president of Mississippi Valley State University for 10 years. Each of these recipients has on a medallion that they were awarded last week, and they received a $1,000 prize. So let me quickly introduce those recipients. You've met one already, so let me just ask him to stand briefly, Traylon Rogers. I won't give you a bio again. Lydia Page Moffitt, member of the Dillard volleyball team of freshman year, sophomore class, vice president, 3-year mock trial team captain, National Black Women's Reproductive Justice Rights Fellow, UNCF Koch Scholar, recently selected to participate in the inaugural GNO Inc. HBCU Startup Internship. She will be attending North Carolina Central University School of Law. Alicia Huey, POTUS Team Director, past SGA Treasurer, Dillard Debate Team, UNCF Koch Scholar, one of 28 women nationally selected for Leadership Delta, White House Initiative for HBCU Scholar, Sadie T.M. Alexander, Economics Research Scholar. Incidentally, she is this year's recipient of the Latrice Sutton Scholarship, named after the wife of William Sutton. She will continue to work at Ochsner Health and Wellness as an accountant. And finally, Caitlin Tanner, 3-year member of the Dillard Track and Cross Country Teams, Center for Racial Justice Advisory Board, past resident assistant, NAACP Legal Defense Fund, HBCU ambassador, National Black Women's Reproductive Justice Rights Fellowship, 17 magazines, Voices of the Year honoree, and of course, Miss Dillard University. She will be attending George Washington University to pursue a master's degree in public health. Please stand if a member of your family also graduated from Dillard University. All Dillard legacy. Thank you. In a year of COVID, healthcare professionals are the real MVPs. So please stand if you are about to begin your career as a nurse. Please stand if you are going to graduate school for public health, nursing, or medicine. All health-related fields graduate program, folks. Please stand if you are beginning any graduate school this fall. People going to graduate school. And then my final group, this year we set a record for the number of students admitted to law school. Only half of black students who apply to law school get in anywhere. At Dillard, over 94% of our pre-law students were admitted to law school. In fact, we have more students going to law than any other graduate or professional program this year, with members of this class going to law school, some who are graduating who will go in subsequent years. So if you are one of the 13 that are beginning law school this fall, please stand. Thank you. I always do unique stories. I'm just going to do one for the day. Nicole Perry, will you please stand? Nicole has the most interesting story this year. Her family was pushing Dillard on her before she even told them she wanted to even go to college. Her mother's exact words were, "I'll pay for Dillard and Dillard only." Her mother attended Dillard in 1981 for nursing, but she attended for only 2 years when the money ran out. In 2003, her brother came to Dillard, but he wasn't able to finish due to Hurricane Katrina in 2005. So in 2017, Nicole enrolled at Dillard as a psychology major and met her own challenges led by COVID-19, but including financial challenges and a newborn baby. But she is the first of those three to complete a Dillard education. At this time, I'd like to bring back Jaleesa Singletary, who will lead us in the singing of Fair Dillard, followed by the benediction by Reverend Brisbane, and then we'll do our conferral of degrees.
Green, we love thy every breath.
class of 2021, receive this Franciscan benediction. May God bless you with discomfort at easy answers, half truths, and superficial relationships so that you may live deep within your heart. May God bless you with the righteous indignation at injustice, oppression, and exploitation of people so that you may work for justice, you may work for freedom, you may work for peace. May God bless you with tears to shed for those who suffer from pain, persons who suffer from rejection and starvation and war, so that you may reach out your hand to comfort them and to turn their pain into joy. May God bless you with enough foolishness to believe that you can make a difference in this world so that you can go with others' claim cannot be done. God in the power, God in the assurance, God in the one who comforts us, may his face continue to rest upon you as you go forth in the power and the assurance of knowing that you are the ones connected with the faith within. Go in his love, go in his power, and go in his peace. Amen.
You may be seated. Graduates, if you are vaccinated and you feel comfortable, you may unmask at this time so that you can come forward and receive your degrees with your gleaming white teeth. As we begin to confer the baccalaureate degrees, Dean Eric Buckles will present the candidates for the College of Arts and Sciences. Interim Dean Dorian Williams will present the candidates for the College of Business. And Dean Sharon Hutchinson will present candidates from the College of Nursing. Will all the candidates for the Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, and Bachelor of Science in Public Health degrees from the College of Arts and Sciences, please stand. President Kimbrough, in accordance with the recommendation of the Dillard University faculty and the vote of the Board of Trustees, I recommend you to confer upon these young women and men the Bachelor of Arts, the Bachelor of Science, and the Bachelor of Science in Public Health in recognition of the successful completion of degree requirements and institutional obligations.
I am pleased to accept the faculty's recommendation and the approval of the Board of Trustees to confer upon these women and men the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, and Bachelor of Science in Public Health with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereunto. Congratulations, you may now approach the stage and receive your degree.
Victoria Robertson, summa cum laude, valedictorian. Traylon Rogers, summa cum laude, valedictorian. Jordan Adams. Shaylen Adams, Allen. Austin Albar. Caitlin Barker. Oh, Tyrone Barrow. Brylan Bergeron, cum laude. Ashley Berry, cum laude. Amber Blunt. Taylor Bosey. Cody Branch, cum laude. Bianca Broomfield, cum laude. Jalen Brown, cum laude. Dominique Buddington, cum laude. Justin Jones. Maya Bush. Ralph Johnson III. Dana Cador. Jaquez Chandler. Ebony Colonies. Emaya Charles. Kiana Cooks, cum laude. Darius Cooper. Colby Cordier. Janelle Cujo. Leah Cunningham. Cheryl Daniels, summa cum laude. Jessica Davis, summa cum laude. Daylon Day, cum laude. Anaya DeCourt. Dion Delpit. Always get it wrong. Taylor DeVere, cum laude. Paige Davis. Lachey Dow, cum laude. Gianni Duncan Mosley. Kaylin Dunn. Tamira Ellison, magna cum laude. Brooklyn Falcon, cum laude. Jai Flowers, cum laude. Caitlin Foster. Elizabeth Gallen. Nadia Hadir. Okay, what they want me to do? Maisha Hagen. Tiara Hamilton. Isaba Abar. Ashton Hosley. Kia Howard, summa cum laude. Jaquel Isidore. Cameron Jackson. Simone Jackson. Deja Jackson. Jada Jenkins. Genesis Johnson, summa cum laude. Grace Johnson. Mariah Johnson. Brietta Jones. Maya Jones, cum laude. Jaja Jordan. Casey King. Jada Lewis. Sharanda Lewis. Yana Lighthall, cum laude. Deja Lindsay. Amiria Littleton. Emily Lopez. Alexandria Lofton. Joa Constant Malik. Jada Manuel cum laude. Damisha cum laude. Justin Matthews cum laude. Bria McCain, cum laude. Ronisha McCardell. Kiara McClue. Kyra McGee. Eric McLaughlin. Kaylin McLaughlin. Davion McKay. Sterling Miller, summa cum laude. Gabrielle Mims. Taylor Mitchell, magna cum laude. De'Ara Maas, summa cum laude. I got to say that whole thing. Lydia Page Moffitt, cum laude. Tayshawn Muller. Jawana Moore, cum laude. Alexis Morgan. Michelle Morrell. Yasmin Neely. Holly Neely. Zaria Nolan. Zachariah Paige Westbrook. Nicole Perry. Taj Pierre. Carlos Pollard Jr., cum laude. Tremichael Poole. Xavier Randolph. Tamish Renard II. Kara Renee. Cabrera Regional. Rachel Riley. Jameson Roberts. Jemiah Mashana Robinson. Jermaine Robinson Jr. I got you. Makeda Royer, cum laude. Tania Roster, cum laude. Demarius Shakespeare. Yeah. Ashley Shopshire. All right. Brenton Smith.
I'm cool, but it wasn't.
Danielle Smith, cum laude. Jody Smith. Toya Smith. Elizabeth Spears. Ronisha Sterling. Dorian Stewart. Kiara Stinson. Kaylin Alexandria Tanner. Haley Taylor. Jadarius Taylor. Jasmine Janelle Thomas. Alicia Thompson. Kyrus Trigg. Tyrese Triggs. Amaria Collins Walker. Congratulations. Jada Washington. Tom Washington Jr. Lanice Webb. Leah West. Rachel West. Camellia White. Nyanka White. Tyann White. Tyranny Wiggins. Arlindria Williams. Honor Williams, cum laude. Jada Williams, cum laude. Taylor Williams. Naja Wilson. Ronisha Wingo. Jeremiah Wright Graham. Maya Young.
Will the candidates for the Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science degrees from the College of Business please stand? President Kimbrough, in accordance with the recommendations from the Dillard University faculty and the vote of the Board of Trustees, I recommend you confer upon these young women and men the Bachelor of Arts and the Bachelor of Science degrees in recognition of the successful completion of degree requirements and institutional obligations.
I am pleased to accept the faculty's recommendation and the approval of the Board of Trustees to confer upon these women and men the degree of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereunto. You may please approach the stage and receive your degree.
Jalen Adams. Elijah Avis. Caitlin Barnes, summa cum laude. Michelle Black. Angelique Boutet, cum laude. Chandler Cyrus. Miguel Jaron, cum laude. Darnicia Harris. Morgan Harrison. Alicia Hui. Daphne Jean Pierre. Kalani Kalinli. Jordan Kane, magna cum laude. Cameron Linton. Lily Mae McLennan. Riaja Mitchell. Milan Morris Ealy. Kayla Munley, cum laude. Alexis Pierre. Precious Richardson, summa cum laude. India Ruffin, magna cum laude. Kyle Stibe, Jr. Mykeisha Tenner, magna cum laude. LaFlora Young, Jr. Taylor Youngblood, cum laude.
And last, but of course certainly not least, will the candidates for the Bachelor of Science degree in nursing from the College of Nursing please stand? President Kimbrough, in accordance with the recommendations of the Dillard University faculty and the vote of the Board of Trustees, I recommend you confer upon these four young women the Bachelor of Science in Nursing degree in recognition of the successful completion of degree requirements and institutional obligations.
I am pleased to accept the faculty's recommendation and the approval of the Board of Trustees to confer upon these women the degree of Bachelor of Science in Nursing with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereunto. Congratulations. Please approach the stage and receive your degrees.
Woo!
The Fantastic Four. Crystal Jaquila Chris. Janae Courtney Wilkerson Knox. Alexis Nicole Sims. Janae Knox was cum laude. Taylor Rosemary Williams Walker J. Bunker Prize.
Thank you.
Right. Bernie, let's get the two of them first. Okay. We got one more. Right, stay right there. She's got something. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
You got it. All right, get out there and fix the world.
Hi, everyone. You know, every year around graduation, I like to make sure that the audience knows who's graduating. These personalized stories. And I actually got this idea when I was at Albany State. The president, Dr. Portia Holmes Shields, would have students stand up in the audience and say where they were going to school or a great job that they got. And I was like, wow, that's a great idea. I should do that. So when I first became a president in 2004 and at my first commencement in 2005, I kept that tradition going. And so I've done that every year. Even last year, as a part of the virtual ceremony, I just read off the names and the things and made sure that people knew about our graduates. But this year, we have a time limitation, only 90 minutes, and I don't have time to really spend the 15 minutes or so that I would have the students stand up. So I decided that we'd supplement what I would normally do, and on commencement day, I'll have a couple of groups stand up. But for individuals, I thought it might be cool for you to actually see and hear from those students, where they're going to school or what kind of job they have. So I want to introduce you to a couple of our graduates of 2021 and some of the things that they're going to be doing. And I hope you'll be inspired by a fantastic class that's really persevered through a lot of different things this year as a part of this pandemic. But they're really going to make us all proud. So let me introduce you to these graduates from 2021 Dillard University.
Hi, I am Kaylin A. Tanner, and I am from Los Angeles, California. I will be receiving a Bachelor's of Science in Urban Studies and Public Policy with a minor in Criminal Justice. I will be attending The George Washington University in Washington, D.C. to obtain my Master's in Public Health.
Greetings and salutations. My name is Justin Matthews. I am from Atlanta, Georgia, and I will be receiving my Bachelor's of Science in Physics from Dillard University. After attending Dillard University, I will be receiving my master's at Georgia Tech in Electrical Engineering as I continue my internship with the Air Force Research Lab.
Hi, my name is Alexis Pierre. I am from Laplace, Louisiana, and I will be receiving a degree in Business Administration with a concentration in Marketing. After Dillard, I will be working as a full-time marketing representative at Dell Technologies in Austin, Texas.
Hey y'all, my name is Traylon T. Rogers. I'm a native of Arlington, Texas. I'll be graduating Dillard University with a Bachelor of Science in Urban Studies and Public Policy. In the fall, I will either attend the University of California, Berkeley Law School or the University of Texas at Austin Law School.
Hi, my name is Cameron Linton. I'm from Houston, Texas, and I'm getting my degree in Business Administration with a concentration in Marketing. And after Dillard, I will be working at Academy's corporate office as their website design coordinator.
My name is Caitlin Barnes. I'm a business administration major from New Orleans, Louisiana. After Dillard, I'll be attending UNO for my MBA, and I'll be interning at Crum & Forster Holdings Corporation.
Hi, everybody. My name is Precious Richardson. I'm from St. Joseph, Louisiana, and I will be receiving my degrees in accounting and financial economics. After Dillard, I will be attending Southern University to receive my JD and MBA.
Hey everybody, my name is Carlos Pollard Jr. I am from New Orleans, Louisiana, and I will be receiving my Bachelor of Arts in Criminal Justice from Dillard University. After undergrad, I'll be working with Powell Coalition for a one-year fellowship before enrolling into law school.
Hello, I am Alicia Hui from Shreveport, Louisiana. I will be finishing Dillard with an accounting degree. After Dillard, I will be continuing working at Ochsner Health and Wellness in the retail accounting department.
Hi, everyone. My name is Jada Jolanda Williams, and I am a native from New Orleans, Louisiana. I will be receiving my Bachelor's of Arts in Theater Performance from Dillard University. After I leave Dillard, I plan on going to Atlanta, Georgia to fulfill my dreams within the entertainment industry.
Hey, y'all. I'm Honor Way Williams, all the way from Atlanta, Georgia. I'll be receiving a degree in the Colleges of Arts and Sciences with a major in chemistry and a minor in mathematics. This fall, I'll be attending either North Carolina A&T or Kennesaw State University to receive a master's degree in chemical sciences and chemistry.
What's up, y'all? I am Camellia White. I am from Memphis, Tennessee. I will be receiving my Bachelor of Arts in Film. After Dillard University, I will be achieving my Master of Arts in Strategic Marketing Communications at Emerson College in Boston, Massachusetts.
Hey y'all, my name is Emaya Charles. I'm from Lafayette, Louisiana. Today I'll be obtaining my Bachelor's of Arts in Criminal Justice with a minor in Psychology. After Dillard, I'll be attending law school at Southern University Law Center in Baton Rouge.
Hello everyone, my name is Damaris Shakespeare. I'm from Hudson, New York. I'll be obtaining a Bachelor's of Arts in Criminal Justice with a minor in English. And after Dillard, I'll be attending FAMU Law.
Hello everyone, my name is Dinah Cador and I'm from Brule, Louisiana. Today I will be receiving my Bachelor of Science in Biology with a minor in Chemistry. And after Dillard University, I will be attending Nicholls State University as a Master of Science in Marine and Environmental Biology student.
Good afternoon, y'all. My name is Eric McLaughlin. I am from Atlanta, Georgia. Today, I'll be receiving my Bachelor's of Arts in Urban Studies and Public Policy. And after graduation, I'll be pursuing a career in urban planning, focusing on affordable housing.
Hey, y'all. My name is Cheryl Daniel from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. And today, I will be receiving my Bachelor's in Arts in Mass Communications. After Dillard, I plan to receive my Master's in Science in Media Advocacy at Northeastern University in Boston.
Fare you well. Ooh.
together. Come on, come on. Somebody give the Lord some praise. He's been good, he's been good, he's been good.
Sure.